Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Go quickly and tell the others.
Ah, Thomas, thankfully you're back. Hey, while you're out, Mary was just telling us about what she saw.
Seriously, again? This is ridiculous. Mary, I told you, that's enough. I think we've all had our fill of your idle tales for the day. He's dead. You're lucky. We're all lucky. We are also.
Lucky? Is that what you think? Is that why you're always so doubtful? Well, guess what? I'm not doubtful. And I'm not afraid. I know what I saw, and it was him. Peter saw him too, right, Peter?
I can't, Mary. If I really saw what I think I saw, I don't deserve to have seen it.
But you did. I told you. I tried telling all of you. He's alive. He's risen somehow.
No,
we've got to find
him. No. Unless I see the nail prints in his hands, unless I can put my hand in his side, you remember where he was pierced? Then I won't believe a word you've got to say.
But he's not there now.
Thomas.
Everyone, please settle down.
We cannot afford to be discovered here. Now, James, we'll check all the doors and windows in this place. Make sure they're shut and secure. Guys, the last few days have been nothing short of disastrous. And I admit, Mary, I'm having trouble believing in what we saw.
That's
enough,
right.
Enough, Thomas. Peter, tell me. Tell all of us. What did you see? Did you see him?
I saw a lot of things, John. We all saw. So what do you mean, what did I see? I saw the miracles. I saw him feed the thousands with 5 loaves of bread and with 2 fish. I saw him heal the blind. He raised the man from the dead. He made the lame to walk. He gave people hope. He did the miraculous. I saw all of that. Yet everyone saw my failure. What's wrong with me? Even after everything I saw, I still lacked faith. I remember when he called me out onto the waves. I was with him. But I failed.
Peter.
No, you don't understand. I failed him. I failed him more than once. I failed him when he needed me the most. I made so many promises to him, but I left him. I left him when they found us in the garden. I abandoned him.
We all did, Peter.
You didn't. You followed him. And I followed you. Guarded by the servant girl. She wouldn't let me in until you came and got me. Do you remember? Now, I just wanted to go through and be with him. So when she asked if I was one of his disciples, I said that I wasn't. It wasn't a big deal. I didn't mean anything by it. I just wanted to see him. I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I got close enough to see him, but it was cold, so I kept my distance. Even though I told them I would always be close. Standing by the fire with the others, I noticed that the high priests were questioning him. Now, I'm not sure what they asked him, but whatever it was, they didn't like his response. One of the soldiers slapped him across the face and it startled me. Maybe that's when it happened. Maybe that's when they noticed me. I tried so hard to fit in, but it was too late. Someone by the fire recognized me. And they asked, Aren't you one of that man's disciples? My heart full of anger. I shouted, I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not one of his disciples. But it was too late. They knew who I was. It was over for me. Didn't I see you in the garden? Shouted the priest's servant. I thought I was protecting him when I cut off that man's ear. But instead, it had come back to haunt me. I was afraid. I was so afraid. I didn't want to suffer just for knowing him. Even though I said I would follow him to the ends of the earth. I don't know this man, I shouted back. I don't know this man. It was then when I heard it. I remember what Jesus had said to me.
Before the rooster crows, you will deny me three times.
I had denied him! I had just denied him! I could feel someone looking at me. I didn't want to face him, but something drew me. As I slowly turned to face him, I saw that his eyes weren't filled with anger and sorrow like I expected to see. But instead, they were filled with love, compassion, and mercy like I had never felt. But how? How could he love me after what I had just done? And why? Why would he choose to reveal himself to me? Why does he love me?
For the way I've thought too much of myself, for the way I've been trusting in my flesh, for the way I've not come to you with tears and brokenness. For the way that I have made you small, for the way I've not noticed you at all. My pride and my fear that won't let me surrender all. Forgive me, I need your mercy. I am not worthy without the cross the days I loved money more than you. For the days I loved secrets more than truth. When I am too busy to reach for the needy or reach for you.
You get up. It's going to be okay.
John, I let him down. So many times I let him down.
You let him down? He let us down. You said it yourself, Peter. We saw all the miracles, but where are they now? Where is he when I need him? We need him the most.
That's what we're trying to understand, Thomas. We don't always have the answers in times like this, but right now is we need to believe beyond what we see. It's faith.
Believe? Faith? That's easy for you to say. You saw him. Everyone saw him. Even she saw him. How can I believe when he feels so far from me? Maybe we would have all been better off.
Better off in the first place? You know what, Thomas? It's bad enough that you're constantly bashing me because of my past, but now you want nothing to do with him?
You're unbelievable. If you really think...
Think about it. He said that all things are possible with him. But here we are, hiding, scared, alone. This isn't exactly in the realm of what I expect to be possible for my life. And I'm sure it's not what you or anyone else expected either.
So that's it. Abandoned ship. Things are going a little rough. You just want to throw in the towel. But let me tell you something.
No, listen, we're not here to see
you,
John.
I remember when he found me. They always said I was crazy, and for most of my life, I guess I was. It wasn't until I met Jesus that everything changed. There's no love stronger than a love that accepts you for who you are. A love that won't allow you to stay the same as you've always been. That morning, I heard a pounding at my door. It was a sound I was afraid to respond to, and I just wished it would go away. The pounding, it got louder and louder. I just wanted to scream. They wouldn't go away. I could hear the sounds of angry men, and I knew whoever was on the other side of that door, they didn't want in. They wanted me out. At any moment, they'd be breaking their way through my door, and then what? In my mind's eye, I could see men with stones in their hands. My heart began to race, and my mind thought of escape, but there was no way out. My door flung open, and my home was filled with so-called religious do-gooders and upstanding citizens of the community, some of which I knew by experience. The two biggest men grabbed me and pulled me to the ground and pulled me out my front door. Outside, a crowd had already formed in the dusty street where I found myself on my face. They yanked me up again and they pushed me through the crowd of faces and pointing fingers while my ears were filled with the sounds of people shouting. I began to weep. They pushed me on the ground again where I found myself on my face. I could see men one by one reaching down and picking up stones. And I knew then that my life was over. It wasn't a good life, but I didn't want to die this way. No, not like this. I had intentions to change someday. I just needed another chance. Somebody please help me. I don't want to die this way. Please help me.
I don't see any!
when I turned to look at him, when I saw him, I saw compassion in his eyes that I had never felt as a child. I wanted to hide myself. Never had I felt such shame. And then he spoke again. Neither do I accuse you. Go and sin no more. From that moment on, I would never be the same again.
You gave your life. always enough for me. Always enough for me.
I was broken beyond repair, and somehow he fixed everything broken inside of me. I know I was never better off without him.
We all understand that, Mary. Our lives were very different before Jesus came into them. We wouldn't be who we are now.
I can't understand how someone could think that we were better off without him.
Our lives are better now?
That's not what I meant, and you know it.
That's where we are right now. Look at where we are. We're all hiding. We're all scared. And don't tell me that none of you are scared. Even John doesn't want to be found out. I'm the only one who's even brave enough to venture out and go get food for everyone. You're welcome, by the way.
I thought it best if we all remained together, and I still think it's the best option for us right now. Thomas, it's not that we're ungrateful for all that you've done. It's just right now you can't think of only yourself. Besides
nothing, John. I walked alongside all of you the past 3 years. I heard all the teachings. I believe with all my heart.
Thomas, you just have to.
Why don't you?
I'm afraid, all right? There, I said it. You happy now?
We're all afraid, Thomas.
No, just stop. I put myself out of my comfort zone with every city we walked through, and I wanted to be the best for him. From the moment he said, follow me, I gave up everything. I changed. I know I've always been a skeptic, but I didn't want to be anymore. He showed me the proof that I needed to believe that every word he said was true. When I was with him, I had no doubts. I wasn't afraid anymore. I could do anything. I could speak anything. I could be bold about what I believe and not worry about what others thought because he was the only one that I cared about. But now, he's not here. I had to stand there in the garden and watch him be bound, beaten, and taken away. And what did I do? I ran. I ran as far away as I could. And now I have nothing to show for the last 3 years. Now I'm stuck in a room full of people who are too scared to even go outside for fear of someone seeing them or something terrible happening to them. And now they're telling me that they've seen him? That he's alive because he revealed himself to them? And what proof do they have? An empty tomb? And stories of things that happened while I just happened to not be here? Why would they tell me that if they hadn't seen him? They wouldn't. Would they? But it doesn't make sense. Because even if he was alive, why would he reveal himself to everyone else except me? But I have no proof. I have nothing to go by but other people's words. And people can lie. People make mistakes. I need more than that. I have to be sure, certain. I can't just go around believing what other people say. I have to know it myself. I have to see his hands and his side, or I won't believe.
I have to protect myself from false hope. I can't be disappointed again. I just can't.
Peace be unto you.
Jesus.
Why are you troubled? And why do thoughts arise in your minds? Flesh and blood the way that I do.
Lord, God.
Thomas, because you've seen me, you believe. But blessed are they who have not seen, and yet they still believe.
God, why did you reveal yourself to everyone else except me? I loved you too. Did I do something wrong?
I know your heart, Thomas. You're always so sure, so confident in everything you know and understand. When you're convinced, there's nobody who can change your mind. Sometimes not even me. But I put it within you to be fearless and bold, to carry your brethren when they are not able to carry themselves. And you have been willing to sacrifice your life by going out and doing something as simple as giving food. Go out of your way for others, Thomas, because you know that they're a part of the same body of faith. And if I put my hand on your shoulder, the rest of your body knows that I'm touching you. But if I reveal myself to this body of believers, why would you not trust them? Just because I did not reveal myself to you in the same way.
Because I was afraid. I was afraid that you left me. You just abandoned us. I was afraid that you lied to me. I was afraid that every word you said wouldn't be true, and we spent all this time following you for no reason. How could I believe anyone else but you?
I know. But sometimes you will have to. I know what you need. That's why I revealed myself to you now. Because I will never leave you. But everything that I endured, I had to. Because it is written that Christ must suffer and die and arise on the third day. And you are all witnesses of these things.
I knew you were alive. I just knew it.
Mary, you have not despaired, even though everything and everyone tried to give you reason. I have seen your heart and the way that you fight for truth and all that is good. You heard me calling you. And have remained strong in spite of fears and doubts and criticism of your past. A past I do not remember. A past that has been covered by the blood that I shed for you on Calvary's cross. You have been faithful. I will remember this, and the rest of the world will know and remember the love and the kindness that you have shown me in even the smallest of things. Simon Peter, do you love me?
Yes, Lord. You know that I love you.
Then feed my lambs. Simon Peter, do you love me?
Yes, Lord. You know that I love you.
Then feed my lambs. Simon Peter, do you love me?
Yes, Lord. You know that I love you.
Then feed my lambs. Don't worry. I know that you love me. I also know that you count me. You are my disciple. Though you make mistakes, you give me your very best. You are never so far gone that I cannot reach you. And there is nothing wrong that you have done that I cannot forgive you. You walked on water. Remember where I have taken you. Even when all you can feel is the sting of your family.
this place. But what do we do now? What about those outside these walls? What about those who have yet to follow us?
All of you are my witnesses. You have seen me, and you know that I am alive. But those who come after you, help them, encourage them, be the example to them of the love and compassion that I have given you. Lift up the weak. Be strength to those who cannot carry themselves. Lift up the downcast. And you shall be called my church. All power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in my name, teaching them to observe whatsoever I have commanded you. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall pick up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. You are the extension of my righteousness in this dark world. I put a light in your hand that nobody can quench, and a thirst and desire in you that only I have created, and only I can fulfill. Do not look for me in places where I am not, because you know where to find me. You know I am right there, right above you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world, because I am not dead. I am alive forevermore.